much we're going to get. I can't see if I got any snow flurries right now because it's dark out. I don't like it when it's dark out this early. Slight chance of snow before 9 a.m. on Tuesday. A high near 37 degrees on Tuesday. That sounds pretty nice. Chance of precipitation is around 20%. A wind could blow as high as 35 miles per hour, though, on Tuesday, which could make it a little bit difficult to see if we do get those flurries. Wednesday, no chances of flurries, but a lot of chances of sunshine. How about that? And a chance it could be fairly warm. You might want to get the scooter out and go for a ride. 48 degrees, west wind 10 to 15, gusts as high as 30. So if you're riding the scooter in your shirt sleeves, you shouldn't do it. You shouldn't ride your scooter in your shirt sleeves anyhow. You should always wear your leather jacket. Because if you don't come behind a shelter belt there and you get the gust of wind to 30, it blows you off the road and you end up in the ditch. You want to be able to slide on your leathers rather than on your skin. Yeah, and that's the point there. Thursday, partly sunny. Excuse me, sunny and 42. Friday, mostly sunny and 30. So that's what the weather looks like. 570 WNEX. Well, Nebraska. They say the worst place to visit in Nebraska. And I don't know about this. Because I think it's beautiful. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. So these people are a little bit, let's just say they're hoity-toity. In my opinion, a little bit hoity-toity about what they consider to be a good tourist destination or not. Pine Bluff's highest point in Nebraska. That's what they say. The Panorama Point. Panorama Point is there in northwestern Nebraska. Extreme western, so you can see Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado all from the same spot. And they're complaining, well, it ain't even a mountain. Nah, it don't have to be no mountain, folks. All right, you're talking about 5,200 and some odd feet elevation, right? So you're almost a mile up, nearly a mile above sea level, and you can see for three states. It's gorgeous. I mean, if you like western Nebraska, it's absolutely gorgeous. Minnesota, take a guess what they claim the worst place to visit in Minnesota is. Mall of America. I go to the Mall of America all the time. There's a hat store right there at the entry. Yeah, I love that hat store. Always go to the hat store. It's just 4.3 miles of consumerism. That's what they say. They don't like the consumerism. It's a monstrous place. It's pretty cool. In North Dakota, it's the turtle. They got a wheel turtle there, big turtle made out of wheels, thousands of rims. And they say, well, it's dumb. It's dumb. That they don't like it. So it looks pretty cool to me. Drive time, who's this? How are you doing, Carolyn? Captain Sully Sullenberger, yes, yes, right. You know, Carolyn, when we go to New York City, all right, we stay at a hotel that is not very far away from where that happened on the Hudson River. In fact, we have walked to the very place, at least on the shore, where that plane landed on the Hudson right there. So it's a remarkable feat that Sullenberger did. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Carolyn, I don't believe anyone lost their lives during that event. So, yeah, I think all lives were saved when Captain Sullenberger landed that. Carolyn, how's the weather there in Scotland today? Well, you know what? Well, Carolyn, maybe what we should do, all right, every so often, maybe we should check in with you just to get the weather from Scotland. How about that? Do you have access to the temperature and you know what it's doing with just by looking outside, right? There you go. Hey, Carolyn. Hang on, Carolyn, hang on. Now, we're going to talk to you off air because we've got to sneak out of here because we have the coaches show. So don't hang up on us, okay, Carolyn? 570 WNAX.
Someone told me recently, when snow is in the ditches, it makes them hungry for lutefisk. They said, as newlyweds, Grace and I moved on our farm, and a Norwegian neighbor said, come to supper. We were served mashed potatoes, lutefisk, melted butter to pour on top, lingonberries, lefse, and lots of black coffee. Ah, we loved our first lutefisk supper. Another great memory from De Smet Farm Mutual Insurance of South Dakota.
It's the Start Something New sales event at Iverson Auto in Mitchell and Huron, and that means great deals on the Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram lineup. Like this 2021 Jeep Cherokee Latitude Lux, offering confidence on the road with standard safety features and amazing technology. Right now, it can be leased for only $279 a month for 39 months and 10,000 miles per year with $999 down. Now through the end of January during the Start Something New sales event at Iverson Auto in Mitchell and Huron or online anytime at iversonauto.com. Stock number 23009. Not all buyers will qualify. See dealer for details.
What should be on your do-it list during these winter months for spring crop input preparation? Here's operations manager for Valley Egg Supply in Gayville and Spink, Jimmy Sapirda.
Right now, guys should just be thinking about their plans for next year, seeing how things went this last year and adjusting whatever they need to. And even if they're not prepaying, at least having the plans in place so that way we know come springtime what needs to be done. We have the right products in place on time so we can get into the fields at the timely manner. So that's the biggest part right now, is just to make sure that we have all our plans in place so it just allows spring to go smoothly.
Is there a lot of adjustment sometime in a farmer's plan?
There can be, sometimes not, but sometimes there can be. And depending on if we think it's going to be a drier pattern or a wetter pattern for weather, you know, there might be different seeds that you try to place in the field. As far as fertilizer, you know, it might depend on if you're trying to build up the soil or if you're just trying to maintain. It all varies with the weather, with the markets. You know, not a whole lot of changes, but just something to maybe look at to always try to get better.
Valley Egg Supply, Gayville and Spink.
The Black Hills Stock Show and Visit Rapid City are rolling out the red carpet January 29th through February 6th as the Black Hills Stock Show and Rodeo takes over Rapid City. Our 10-day schedule is packed full of events for everybody, including rodeos, the Cinch Trade Show, Truck to Vendor Horse Sale, Hubbard Feeds 10 Breeds of Cattle Sales, and the ShowRite Youth Beef Show has expanded to include sheep and goats. The Wild Costume Bronc Ride is back at the James Kerstad Event Center, along with Bronx for Breakfast and the original and official Ranch Rodeo. We've got the nightlife covered too, with music from Chelsea D and Company, Brandon Jones, the Garage Boys, and Co Wetzel and Chris Colston headlining the Stock Show Stampede February 5th. Some events have tickets and a lot are free of charge. Visit BlackHillsStockShow.com for all tickets, event schedules, and hotel packages. And follow us on Facebook for the latest information. Make plans now to head for the hills, January 29th through February 6th, for the Black Hills Stock Show and Rodeo in Rapid City.
This is okay, WNAX Yankton.
Yep, thanks.
It's 6 o'clock.
I just wasn't hearing crowd noise. Oh, it's going to be that kind of night. Okay.
Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, brought to you by Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Sanford Health. Health lives here. Case IH. Step up your game with top-performing Case IH equipment. State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original and your sports headquarters. Midco SN. This is how we do sports. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Now, this is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome inside the President's Suite here at Dana J. DeKalb Stadium. We are up on the sixth floor of the West Tower. What a beautiful view it is of the snow coming down here on the north side of the SDSU campus in Brookings. We certainly hope everybody is staying safe and warm on this Martin Luther King Day. And welcome to our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. For the next hour, we'll be talking SDSU hoops with women's coach Aaron Johnston and men's coach Eric Henderson. Of course, there's a little more to talk about with the women than the men because of this darn COVID-19 pandemic we are all dealing with. So the men's games last weekend were wiped out, and the Jacks were unable to align anything to be able to make things up. So no men's games to talk about. The women did have a couple of road victories at Omaha. Before we tell you about that, want to tell you about our friends at Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, our presenting sponsor of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. They have takeout available as well as options for in-restaurant dining. If you get takeout, a free beer to go while you wait for your takeout order. They have their Wisconsin cheese soup, their homemade chili. So we invite you to take a stop down to Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. And, of course, when the Jackrabbits play home or away, you can watch the games while you have lunch or dinner as well at Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, your Jackrabbit headquarters. We're talking about the SDSU women again. Two games that played out very similarly. Defense was excellent in both. We'll talk with AJ about those. 62-50 was the win on Friday afternoon. Maya Selland joins the 1,000-point club. The Letcher native led the way with 20 points. She also had 7 rebounds and 5 assists. Peyton Burkhardt added 12. Jack's win, despite only making 3 of 21 threes and going 9 of 16 from the free throw line, because they held Omaha to 38% shooting and plus 8 on the glass. Then the next day, Jacks turn around, pick up a 64-54 win. Both those games, Jacks really pulled away in the second half after close first halves, of which they trailed at times, but played well down the stretch. Selland goes for 15 and 8 rebounds on Saturday. Torrey Nelson, Peyton Burkhardt each added 12, and Madison Velostin has a career-best 9-point effort in that victory on Saturday. So the Jackrabbit women find themselves 4-0, tied with the University of South Dakota atop the Summit League. On the men's side of things, Eric Henderson's squad is 2-0 in conference play, and you have one other unbeaten at 4-0 USD. The men, it's all over the map, because you have teams that have played just 2 games, teams that have played 4, teams that have played 6. So it's starting to become a mess trying to figure things out because of some of these games lost due to the COVID-19 situation. But we'll talk more about that. The Summit League basketball tournaments have been moved in from the Denny Sanford Premier Center to the Sanford Pentagon, and no fans will be allowed in. That the announcement earlier this week from the Summit League, actually last week, I should say. We'll talk about that with the coaches as well. It's all coming up. Again, you can find us on YouTube. Search Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, and you'll be able to see our live stream from our President's Suite here at Dana J. DeKalb Stadium. You can also listen in on your Jackrabbit app. The links to both are on the Jackrabbit app. If you do not have that, we invite you to log into your Google Play or Apple Store and download the Jackrabbit app today. Much more to come from our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Again, we'll hear from Eric Henderson in the back half hour, but right after this, head coach of the SDSU Women, Aaron Johnston, with us to talk about those two victories at Omaha and preview home dates scheduled for Friday and Saturday against North Dakota. This is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Let's be real. When it's time to start adulting, teens need a bank account, like a Real Deal bank account, one that's free and offers some perks. Check out Real Deal Checking from First Bank and Trust. It's free checking with ATM fee refunds, a free custom image debit card, and cash rewards when you qualify. You get free mobile banking with all its cool capabilities, and seriously, your personal finance teacher would be so impressed. Real Deal Checking by First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. For full details, visit bankeasy.com or stop in today.
Member FDIC.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer. Forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting. Based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
Here we go.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Welcome back inside the Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium West Tower. We are in the President's Suite. I'm Tyler Merriam, along with the head coach of the SDSU women's basketball team, Aaron Johnston. I mentioned Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, our presenting sponsor, and we hope that in the months ahead, we're able to get through this pandemic and get back to Cubby's and have that great fan base we always have there every Monday night down there and get to enjoy. That's part of it, the socializing, getting to see everybody down there on Monday nights. We miss that.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, and it's Cubby's have been a great, you know, host for this event, but for a lot of other things too. And everybody just wants to get out and connect, you know, more than anything. And in this case, talk about Jackrabbit Athletics and, you know, connect with fans. We enjoy doing that and having our student athletes go down there and our fans get a chance to hear from them, but also see them, talk to them. Oftentimes they bring their, you know, friends down there too, the other teammates. So that's one of the great things about SDSU and Brookings is just that interactive dimension that you get. It doesn't feel like the athletic department is kind of doing their own thing. We're all very intertwined with the community, and I think people appreciate that. So, you know, this is still good. We get a chance to do this, but no doubt getting back to that other way of doing it will be better too.
What has recruiting been like? And we'll talk about the games at Omaha in just a moment. But from a recruiting standpoint, we discuss here some of the things that are different. I mean, how are you accomplishing things when you can't show off campus in person? You can't be as aggressive in going to watch games as you typically would. How are you handling all of this as a staff?
You know, it's moving forward. Just like everything, you find other ways to do your job. I don't think there's any program, we're certainly, you know, fit this too, that are just kind of sitting on their hands waiting for things to open up. High schools have done a fantastic job of streaming their sports. And sometimes I'm sure it's a revenue stream because they're not having as many people come. But also just giving families who maybe can't go to the games opportunities. So that helps us as coaches. So in terms of access to watching players, we probably have more access now than if we were going out and doing it, because we can watch, you know, 2-3 games in a night if we want to, you know. So we're seeing plenty of people out there, and that's a good thing. And I would say the same for them. They're seeing us play. I mean, we're streamed all the time, and people who are interested in South Dakota State are watching games. And then as far as the campus feel, that's the hardest part. You know, we'll do Zooms, and we'll have some really good discussions, and we'll show some, you know, things that we can do with the recruiting process to really give them a picture. But until you get your feet on the ground and you're walking around campus and they get a chance to meet with an actual advisor or even a professor here and feel that, you know, comfort level with the people they're going to be seeing, that's probably the one dimension you just can't quite simulate. But people get a good picture of SDSU. You'd be surprised too how much recruiting is just word of mouth, and people that have played here in the past or are connected with our program are still out there, you know, and I'm sure planting seeds and doing things that they want to do on their own. So the process is still moving forward, and I think it's been really productive. The seniors now are the ones that probably have, the juniors now, the 22 class, are the ones that probably have the tougher time, because there'll be quite a few of them that either have or maybe will make some decisions without having taken those several campus visits that a lot of other classes got to do.
And I guess with some of the kids that you're recruiting, they have been on campus in the past for camps or whatnot, so maybe you can't show them when it's Mike Jewett walking them around or Carissa or yourself, show them, hey, here's where you're going to eat, here's one of the dorms, but at least they're familiar with the layout in general.
Yeah, you know, absolutely, and that's kind of what I mean. That 22 class kind of fits into it. Like the 24 and the 23 class, they're young enough where I think they're going to have opportunities. You know, we all hope that that's going to get to that point. The 21 class that signed in the fall, you know, their visits and most of their things were done before this happened. But you're right, you know, I think they have to figure out ways to do that, and I still think they'll get those, but they might not have the multiple chances, because I do feel like most of the players that come here visit campus several times through a camp, unofficial visits, come to a game, an official visit. They might not get that many touches, but they'll still have a chance hopefully to get here and kind of see what we're all about. So it's actually moved along pretty well, and I don't think it's really – it's very different. I shouldn't say it hasn't been impacted. It's very different what we do, but it's still moving forward.
And some of that, too, I mean, let's be honest, a sales pitch is better in person than it is over Zoom or whatever it may be, and so you got to find different ways to connect, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we can talk through the screens, and that's good, but that's still very different than sitting and talking and maybe coming and watching a practice. You know, that's a great way to see how people interact. Coming and having, you know, lunch or something like that on campus for a visit and meeting players, those things are all an important part that are harder to do right now, so you have to be a little bit more creative. But I'll be honest with you, you know, when it first started happening, I think we were all as coaches feeling like, oh boy, what are you going to do? But you just figure things out, you know, you improvise like we've all had to do in every business and every walk of life, and it's actually moving along pretty good. So if that's created a safer way to do it because of, you know, the virus, then so be it. I think everybody's going to be just fine, and people end up probably where they're supposed to end up.
And one last point here before we talk about the games at Omaha, this kind of naturally transitions into an opportunity to highlight your coaching staff, because, again, it's not Aaron Johnston's program. There's so many other people involved in the recruiting process and getting these kids on campus and whatnot.
Yeah, you know, Mike, Megan, and Chris are the ones that are doing the lion's share of that work of interacting with people, following people, and calling, and they do a great job of really highlighting South Dakota State. They're all very familiar with what we do. You know, Mike and Chris in particular have been here a long time. Megan has done a fantastic job of just integrating herself to what it is we do and what makes South Dakota State a great place. So they're obviously working with our current players, but they're really laying the foundation for those future Jackrabbits and building relationships with those coaches. And then Kristen and Macy, you know, they do a great job too. They're both past players. When people come to campus and visit, they can talk to a parent or even their daughter about what it was like to actually be a Jackrabbit. And those are fantastic, you know, asset for us to be able to utilize. So they bring a great approach there. Our staff does a good job with all the social media and fun stuff that people interact with right now, things that I don't know a heck of a lot about. But with our young kids at home, I'm probably going to have to learn more about as a parent, I'm guessing. But, yeah, it's just a big, big process of recruiting. And our staff does a fantastic job, I think, of connecting and really highlighting why South Dakota State is such a great place.
Yeah, Rotard in particular does such a great job with social media. And, by the way, we're working on a piece, the video blog with Lindsay Thunick, which hadn't been back yet this year. We're going to get that back going, and putting some stuff together earlier today was a lot of fun. Of all the people to host it, Lindsay's the perfect one.
Oh, yeah. She is a social media person. It's funny, on the clips that I've watched, and I don't see these, you know, until sometimes they're put out. You know, sure. It's just not my area. Every question when we're asking players, you know, who's most likely to be famous or whatever the question is, Lindsay, everybody says the same thing. So I think our team has pretty high expectations for Lindsay and her vlogging. So, yeah.
But as we plan forward, and Lindsay, we're not pushing you out the door here, but the next up, Lindsay's even said, you know, I know Mesa's coming after this. Mesa Byam wants this thing. Rotert, you can't give it to her quite yet.
I could see Mesa doing that too. Again, I've heard from our coaches and players, Mesa's pretty active in that area. So they just have such fun personalities. And we see them on the court, all of our players. And you see such a competitive, serious side. It could be men's sports, women's sports. It's just such a joy to get to know them in a different way. Because all of them are more than a basketball player or a swimmer or a runner or whatever it might be. They just have such a big part of their life that is never really showcased other than the sport. And for us as coaches, we just know each other in such a different way. And the same is true of coaches. You know, people will sit and watch our coaches, me included, and all of our other sports, and probably watch from the stands and think you maybe know somebody, but really you don't. It's what they do as a job. So we really get to spend the kind of time together where we get to see those other pieces, and that's a fun thing for us as coaches and, I think, athletes. A
couple of wins on Friday and Saturday on the road at Omaha, and Baxter Arena is one of those facilities which is a combination basketball-hockey arena. Denver has one, although they've moved the basketball games out of there this year, and you've played some in Hamilton's gym, that gym next door, as opposed to Madness Arena for the women in the past. There are other facilities that are that joint setup, so you're used to that. But one of the things that I know Scotty talked about it on the air both Friday and Saturday is when you play there, sometimes they've got it's so cold because of the ice. I mean, it's sometimes 60 degrees down there when you're trying to play basketball.
Yeah, I'm not a hockey arena basketball fan. It is, and I know it sounds like whining on my part, but it is different, especially if you're an athlete, because you're out there trying to get loose, trying to get warmed up. Yeah. You know, our players that don't start, and maybe they sit out for the first 5-6 minutes, and they're sitting on that basically ice that has, you know, half inch of whatever it is.
Yeah, that particle plastic, board or whatever, yeah.
I mean, they feel it, you know. But it's a beautiful arena. There's no question. It is a beautiful arena, and that's a great place for them to host their events. But it is chilly. There's no doubt about it.
And the highlight of these two games is Maya Selland and the fact that on Friday she not only scored 20 points but eclipses the 1,000-point plateau during her time at South Dakota State. And what an honor for the Letcher native. We've talked about her so much, but we need to take a step back and say, look at what she's accomplished here, 1,000 points already in her Jackrabbit tenure.
Yeah, you know, I'm a big believer in really trying to recognize and continue to you know, highlight people that have that kind of continued success. Because I do believe when people do it over and over again, nobody tries to, but it just gets taken for granted. And she is such a good player, such a great teammate, such a great Jackrabbit. And I know as a coach, I appreciate the heck out of everything she does and can do. And just because she's had so much success early on, doesn't mean that what happens out there is easy. You know, she works really hard. She comes in and does a ton of extra shooting, skill work. Obviously, she's had to overcome some injuries and things to get to this point. So, yes, really talented and a lot of natural ability, but it doesn't end there with Maya. She works incredibly hard at her game and tries to improve. That is kind of a contagious thing, so it pulls other people and makes us a better team. So, you know, that milestone for her is fantastic, and she's got a lot of basketball in front of her and a lot of great things she's going to do. And yeah, really great to honor her. And we've had so many 1,000-point scorers, it's almost like people just assume that's a hard thing to do. It is really a hard thing to do. And Maya's, you know, kind of just getting started, so that's fun to see.
Yeah, and obviously she did benefit some from having a few extra games last year in a year that doesn't count. But nevertheless, still, even if she plays that full year, we'd be in the middle of that junior year, right? I mean, it's remarkable what she's put together.
Yeah, no doubt. If you look at her games, that's about where she'd be. And the other piece of that, you know, when you just look at her games, half half of those games, she was probably 70% of herself. Yeah. You know, she was playing through injuries. It wasn't like she was healthy in all of those. And she played with some really good players as well who could mm-hmm. score. So she's always been able to find a way to help the team, and it wasn't always just high-volume shots. You know, she can really impact the game. Like this weekend, scored 15 points on Saturday, but was still incredibly important to what we were doing. It doesn't take 25 points from her to really – you know, move us along. So, yeah, no, she's doing great and really proud of her and excited to see what comes.
Two stories about Maya that stand out. One is just a fact is that 2 years ago, you guys, or 3 years ago now, I mean, you're playing Oregon. I guess it was 2 years ago. I can't count now. You're playing Oregon in the home game in the regular season, and you got, as you mentioned, you got Maddie Giebert and Macy Miller out there, and you're running plays in the final minute for Sellin to try to get this thing to overtime or win. You're not drawing them up for Macy. You're not drawing them up for Maddie. What a compliment that is to Maya Sellin. But the other point, too, you mentioned her unselfishness. That game against Gonzaga when Thunick hits the three, mm-hmm. she drives and kicks, and she was asked, well, hey, why did you pass that up? Well, Lindsay was open. It wasn't I needed to shoot it. It was Lindsay's open, so I'm going to kick it to her.
Yep, absolutely. That's just her personality, and I think it always has been. I think she certainly can score and understands the value of that, but I think she understands the value of us getting great shots, and that sometimes is her, but sometimes is other people. And as simple as that sounds, there are a lot of great players that maybe approach that differently. You know, yeah. they feel like I've got to be the one to take that, and there's value in that too at times. But Maya is someone that's going to help our team win in a variety of ways. You know, I'm glad it worked out. She's a Jackrabbit. I think, if I remember right, in the recruiting process, Coach Jewett beat her in a game of horse or pig, maybe in her home gym
Ooh,
when we
yes.
went to visit. So I was really worried that you know, loss might deter her from coming. But she handled it with grace, as always, and she's still a Jackrabbit and doing really good.
Well, Jewett must have cheated.
Well, I was talking with the parents, so I'm not sure what was going on. I don't know who was, you know, cheating or making shots, but I think it went that way. I'll ask Maya. Maybe Maya remembers it as a win for Maya. I'll have to verify that story.
We will get to the bottom of this. We'll also talk about the impressive defensive efforts at Omaha and more when our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues. We are live thanks to our friends at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Stay tuned. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Let's be real. You earn, you save, you plan, you protect. If you want to secure your legacy,
Thank you. I was...
First Bank and Trust offers savvy financial planning from people who understand where you are and where you want to go. We can help you navigate your options and build for the future, whatever that may be. We're big enough to help you plan for tomorrow and small enough to start with today. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal opportunity lender.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer. Forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting. Based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Director's Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
One minute.
Take the crown. Visit Royal River in Flandreau. Blast your way through winter at Royal River in Flandreau. Every Friday and Saturday from 5 to 10 p.m. You could win a Cub Cadet snow thrower and earn entries to win a new Kawasaki Mule plus winch and blade on February 27th. Plus, wake up Royal every Wednesday from 8 to 8. Earn 100 points on your Royal Rewards card and receive your Brentwood appliance. First come, first serve. Royal River Casino Hotel. Must be 21.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. We welcome you back inside the West Tower of Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. We're up here on the sixth floor inside President Dunn's suite where he watches football games. We're supposed to have some football games coming up here in March, as a matter of fact. We were watching some of the special teamers getting some work in here earlier tonight as the snow falls here in Brookings. I'm Tyler Merriam with the head coach of the SDSU Women, Aaron Johnston. AJ's team knocking on the door of the top 25, a couple of road wins at Omaha. And defensively, the story of both of these games, at least from watching it and analyzing the numbers, 38% you hold Omaha to the first game, 37.5% the second game. Defensively played very well in both of these.
You know, we did. I really like just how hard our team played. I thought that was a big part of it. You know, Omaha really can match up well with us. They played a lineup that was very similar to ours. They were big at the 4-5 and even the 3 position, and I think one of the first teams that's had that maybe in a while, so that was unique to us. I still think we missed a lot of shots in that first game and certainly could have made more. Had a lot of really good looks. We took care of the ball and didn't make a lot of free throws, but defensively we played very well and kind of kept the game where we needed it to. Then in the final few minutes we made some shots and made some plays to get going. Maya was very good in that game, as we talked about before, but we also had good performances from others. But it was just a matter of not really making enough shots to kind of jumpstart us and get us going, because that is really what it comes down to. You have to be able to make shots, I think, to move forward offensively. But we executed well, and defensively, to your point, we did a lot of good things. One of our better rebounding games against that size and athleticism. We were really good in transition in that game. So it was a good road win. And I know Omaha's record is still, I think, deceptive. They've had to deal with some COVID, so they've been in and out. But they've got a very athletic, very good defensive team, and they're hard to score on.
Well, let's face it. I mean, Pilakuta, if she's on a Jackrabbit or a Coyote team, they're talking about her being one of the best in the league. She kind of gets forgotten about, but she is a force for that Omaha squad.
Yeah, you know, she did a really nice job, to her credit. Really scored inside, forced us to help in a lot of areas, which created some other shots for people. We probably fouled a little bit too much in that game. That spilled into the next as well. But she just puts a lot of pressure on your interior game, because she can score with her back to the basket at a very high level. So now you've got to figure out how you want to handle that, and that's what creates opportunities for the others. But I still thought we were able to kind of get through that. You know, you're not giving up threes, so she's going to get some points. We weren't just going to completely overcommit and let some of those other players get going, but she did a nice job for them.
I mean this as a compliment. When you go on the road and you shoot 14% from three and 56 at the free throw line, it's hard to win. To find a way to win, we go back to that defense again. That's an impressive thing because, again, those numbers don't add up to a victory on the road typically.
Yeah, it is hard. And I think that's, again, where I'm excited about our team getting that done, because, you know, I think kind of like we talked about, you know, how good Maya is, and you kind of sometimes it's easy to take that for granted. You know, when you're winning, you can feel like you have to play, you know, perfect all the time, or that means you're not playing well. And it's just nobody plays perfect all the time. It just doesn't work that way. The difference between good teams and teams that struggle are sometimes good teams can find a way to get a win when things don't go your way. And that was the case, I thought, on Friday. We were really good defensively when we had to be, and we found a way to score enough points. And that's a really good compliment, I think, for our team, and I think we certainly take it that way too.
Madison Boston in Saturday's game, a career-high 9. She hits 3 threes, and I know you have high hopes for the South Dakota.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, that was really she hit some threes since Christmas, so she shot it better since we've come back. But that was one of the games we just felt like when she let it go, it's going in. Sid Stapleton hit a big shot in that game for us, too. Having Maddie and Sid on the floor in that stretch in the kind of the third and fourth, that's what really got us a cushion. Those two played, I thought, great offensively, making shots, just being able to spread the floor. Tori had a couple big baskets late. She had a two-point shot going to the rim and hit a big three late out of a timeout, and that was really important for us. So yeah, that game, again, I thought we played really well defensively. We just fouled too much. I think they shot 20, maybe one free throws. That's just too many free throws, you know, and it's hard to beat a team on the road when you do that, as you said, but we found a way. Without fouling, though, our half-court defense was really good. I mean, they didn't shoot the ball well or get a lot of easy looks. That's a game where we shot it well in that game, but that one we turned it over too much. So we just kind of flipped the offense from the first night. Definitely shot it better on Saturday, but we just gave it up too many times. So, you know, both games we can find things that we have to improve on, but the big thing was to go on the road and find a way to try and get two wins, and that's what we did. And we did it with some balance on that second night. You know, Peyton had a good solid game, but Tori had a really good game. Ty scored for us a little bit. We just talked about Sid and Maddie off the bench, and so there was a lot of balance in that game. And the other part, too, is if you look at Omaha, they don't play at a fast pace. So that isn't going to be a Western Illinois where you're going to score 80 points. You know, that's going to be games that are in the mid-60s, 70s, unless you just shoot the lights out. Mm-hmm. So really based on style, you know, I feel like it was a productive weekend for us.
For your team, which is obviously a very good team to become great, they're not that far away. It's that consistency off the bench, which you're starting to get more of. Is that really what separates it right now?
Yeah, I think so. You know, Sid as a junior is playing for us off the bench. We're bringing Haley right now off the bench. So we have a little bit of experience right there coming in. We've used Jordan some too as a junior. Other than that, they're young players. You know, they're very young players playing for us off the bench, and they've got to continue to learn and grow. But consistency is absolutely the word. You know, Mesa doesn't have to just be somebody different, but she's got to be where she is every single day, and Maddie and those players. Reagan's another good example of it. So, and you expect that from young players. That's why they're there. But consistency will help the team move forward for sure, and I think we're going to get there. You know, our November and December were tough. I mean, we were playing really good teams. There were no easy ones, just to get your confidence going. So I think, it's going to be a long process for those young players, as it typically is, but they'll continue to find that consistency as we go forward.
Let's talk about the games Friday and Saturday scheduled against North Dakota. We have to italicize that every time we talk about games these days. This is a North Dakota team, and you mentioned it with Omaha, too. You look at the standings, and you see North Dakota hasn't won a game. Okay. But I watched a lot of their two games when they hosted North Dakota State last weekend. They lose both in the final seconds, one in overtime. Played NDSU very well. They've lost 3 games in overtime this year. I mean, they've only been blown out, I think, once this season. So there's a lot to this UND team, again, with a new coach as well.
Yeah, another just really deceiving record. That's not coach speak. You just gave some of the stats right there. You know, they're a very athletic team. They're very big and physical inside. So that we had that trouble with Omaha. We're going to have to find a little bit better plan there. They play really hard. This will probably be a game that's both games have a little more tempo and pace to them, not necessarily half-court grinded out games. They defend with a lot of physicality. I mean, this is a game that we don't want to get into a foul contest with them, so we'll have to improve on that from this past weekend. And we're going to have to find some consistency making shots, because they'll try and take away our inside game, which has been our strength. And so we're going to have to find some consistency on that three-point line. But you know, I really like how our team has defended. Megan and Mike really handle a lot of that. Those assistant coaches are doing a great job getting us in a good plan and giving us confidence in every game to feel like we can be in it. And so our offense will have to be a little more consistency to kind of match that. But we're excited to be back at home. You know, Frost has been great. Our team is enjoying this opportunity that they're getting to play. They're just having a lot of fun with it, and we'll try and keep it going.
How have they handled all this?
You know, I think it's stressful because there's a lot, you know, and it's not just basketball. You know, that's the thing we keep reminding them. There's a lot that they have to think about with basketball, but they have family members that are dealing with COVID. They've got family members that maybe haven't been able to work consistently. They've got siblings that are dealing with it. So basketball is still one piece of their big picture. Just figuring out is class, you know, online, all these things that everybody else is dealing with, they're doing too. So that's the part that I think gets a little overwhelming. The basketball part is kind of that release. You know, they love to do it. The testing we have to do, those are small sacrifices to be able to play. But it's just balancing everything else in their life because, as I said in our first section, they're just so much more than basketball players, you know, and we have to make sure that we're respectful of the things they've got to deal with day to day.
Friday and Saturday, 5 o'clock doubleheaders scheduled inside Frost Arena. The women hosting North Dakota, then the men will have game two. Radio coverage starts at 4:30 each day here on these same stations. Coach, congratulations and good luck on Friday and Saturday.
Okay, thank you.
Women's basketball coach Aaron Johnston. On the other side, men's coach Eric Henderson joins us as Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Back with more in just a moment on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Let's be real. When it's time to start adulting, teens need a bank account. Like a real deal bank account. One that's free and offers some perks. Check out Real Deal Checking from First Bank and Trust. It's free checking with ATM fee refunds, a free custom image debit card, and cash rewards when you qualify. You get free mobile banking with all its cool capabilities. And seriously, your personal finance teacher would be so impressed. Real Deal Checking by First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. For full details, visit bankeasy.com or stop in today.
Member FDIC.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer, forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting, based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
1 minute.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Our friends at Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, your Jackrabbit game day headquarters. Anytime there's an SDSU athletics event, whether it's on the road or due to limited attendance at Frost Arena, you can't get there, stop by Cubby's. Before or after the game, you can stop there as well. They have to-go. You can go inside, pick it up. get a free drink while you're waiting for your to-go order, or they'll bring it out curbside or even have alley side pickup. You can pull into the alley there on the west side, and they'll bring it out to you. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, Jeremy, Gus, and Stolten, the crew down there, do a great job, and we can't wait to be back there in person, but for now, we'll make the best we can up here in the President's Suite at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, Main Avenue, downtown Brookings, the presenting sponsor of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Hi again, friends. I'm Tyler Merriam, and joining us, the head coach of the men's basketball program, Eric Henderson. Coach, we went a little longer with AJ because we had a little more to talk about since the women had two games and you didn't, unfortunately. Tell me what this past week was like.
Well, it was an interesting week. You know, obviously, we got the news on Monday that we weren't going to be able to play, and so that was obviously really disappointing, but obviously understandable. First and foremost, you got to keep your kids safe, and that's everybody. You know, you want to put that at the forefront. And then, you know, we worked with our commissioner and you know, the Summit League to try to find games, because our first choice was to play in league. You know, we wanted to make sure we were healthy. And so when we're healthy, you want to play. And, you know, nothing really worked out, and we just couldn't get nothing in league. And so then the Summit League decided to, you know, hey, if you can get something out of, you know, a non-conference Division I game, you'd be able to do that. But we probably made about 50 calls in the next 2 days, you know, that Tuesday and Wednesday, even Thursday, you know, just watching, you know, the schedule and who was dropping, what games were dropping, and who was healthy and who was not. And, you know, a lot of the leagues are, you know, trying to take care of each other, you know, first. And so that's kind of what they did for the most part. And we were kind of stuck there with nothing at the end. But you know, like we've said, Tyler, I've talked to you about this. It was a good time to get in the gym and mm-hmm. continue to stay healthy. You know, it's really exciting this past week, and then even, you know, yesterday and today, practicing. We had our whole group together for the first time really all year. And, it brought a smile. We were talking as a staff, you know, after practice today, how much energy was in the gym and how much enthusiasm and what it's like to have everybody going at the same time. So it was disappointing, but it was a good time to get some situations in during practice and get some skill development in and continue to get healthy.
AJ talked about it a little bit on the women's side too, but again, when you get the guys in the gym, and I'm sure it is for you as well, it's a release of sorts that everything can kind of go by the wayside for at least a couple of hours, and hey, this feels normal. We can just get back to what we came here to do, which is to play basketball.
Yeah, you're right, and you know, they're affected in a lot of different ways. You know, we just think, you know, as sports junkies and basketball guys, you know, we just think, oh, it's all basketball all the time. Yeah. But, you know, their school's affected, their families are affected, and obviously basketball's been affected too. And if you can just kind of shut everything off while you're in the gym, and whether you're just getting a workout in and getting shots up or practice with your buddies, you feel pretty fortunate.
You talked about getting everybody together. One of those guys, it's hard sometimes to get him in with the rest because of his class schedule, is Aaron Fegan, the pride of Madison. And, of course, a Jackrabbit family and, you know, Tony, his brother, such a key contributor on multiple Summit League Tournament Championship teams. And Aaron's story, we've documented it before, going through brain surgery to overcome issues with seizures, and he's had a great response to that. It's amazing to think a year and a half ago he had brain surgery, and a few months later he's out there playing basketball. It's a wonderful story. To see him, to see his contributions, he speaks to the team at the end of workouts, which I don't think people always realize because they're not there, and I'm privy to that. What a cool kid, Aaron Fegan.
Yeah, really, like you started off with, cool family, you yes. know, and the history and the tradition they have at South Dakota State is pretty special with Tony. And you know, Ed is, you know, doesn't miss many games, whatever sport it is, Ed and Patty. So it's pretty cool. But to watch Aaron continue to progress, you know, obviously he had that big bump in the road. And, mm-hmm. you know, it really has made him stronger. And I think appreciate the opportunity that you have and really to enjoy every moment. And, you know, I think that rattles through our team when things like that happen. So just to enjoy that moment and to watch Aaron, you know, get stronger and continue to develop his game and stay patient, which has been hard. I know it's hard. It's hard for a lot of guys, you know, but Aaron's done a tremendous job, especially in practices. You know, he competes, you know, every single day. And, he, you know, he had a great finish again today. And we when he's aggressive, it's fun to see, you know. And
he's
so,
a long kid.
Oh, absolutely. And that, you know, you can get that mentality, you know, going. It's pretty cool. But he does it everywhere. You know, he's a special student, you know, great teammate, and, you know, really good basketball player.
And we speak of great teammates. I know one thing, Aaron and I have talked about it. Ed has shared some stories with me as well, his father, about the fact that when he was going through some of this stuff, not only in documenting it and making sure Aaron fully understood what he was dealing with going into it, but also in the recuperation and the rehabilitation after that surgery a year and a half ago, his teammates, you know, some of the guys that have left, some of the guys that are still here, those guys and the role they played. And it speaks to, again, what we talk about so often. There's more than just 40 minutes on a Friday or Saturday night in Summit League play. There's so much more to this experience.
Well, it's ironic that you're saying that on Martin Luther King Jr. Day, you know, Tyler. And, you know, when I think, you know, MLK, Dr. King, you know, I think of love. And love your neighbor. Doesn't matter what color you are. Just love your neighbor. And the you know, it goes to the team as well. And, you know, when Aaron was going through that, the love that our teammates showed and the love back that Aaron showed was just tremendous, you know, and especially his roommates, you know, whether it was Matty Mims or Owen King, who now left, you know, those guys were absolutely phenomenal. And the support system that you have within our team is really, really special.
And we talk about Martin Luther King Day, and again, having so many individuals on your roster from such different walks of life, and Douglas Wilson's background and upbringing is totally different than Matt Mims, which is totally different than David Winget, which is totally different than Aaron Fegan, and we could go down the line. But some programs, a day like this just resonates a little bit more, and it specifically does with your men's basketball team.
Well, I think, you know, that educator in my heart kind of comes out these days, you know, days like this where really, you know, we're teachers, and to help our young men grow, whether it's, you know, current events that are happening or remembering just remarkable people like Dr. King, you know. So after practice today, you know, Coach Barnes had a video ready to go that we watched about Dr. King, and to be able to have a, you know, just a talk and discussion about, you know, his impact on our country and the people in our country was pretty special. And like you said, to have different races on our team speak to, you know, their different experiences. Mm-hmm. But it all, like I said before, comes back to love. And we can learn a lot from that. And everybody's different. Everybody's different. That's the beauty of being you. And so it's pretty cool to be able to talk about something like that today.
And one last point here before we wrap this up. We're talking about love and all this. As some may know, there was an incident that occurred last week on campus. And that was something that, from Athletic Director Justin Sell on down, I know he talked to you, put out a message just to, in support, that this is a great reminder, Martin Luther King Day today, again, of, like you said, love each other. And that love, we talk about it within the team, you and those guys, but from Justin on down, I mean, all the stuff that's gone on. Matt Mims is a member of that Diversity and Athletics Council, as is assistant coach Tremel Barnes, that Justin helped to create here over the past few months because of stuff that's gone down, and just to try to make everybody feel safe and warm and kind of get those fuzzy feelings, if you can do that here at South Dakota State.
Yeah, we're so fortunate for the leadership we have. Like you said, Justin is absolutely phenomenal. And you know, when that happened, you know, he comes, you know, to our practice, which, you know, it's pretty cool that just, you know, your athletic director feels comfortable and say, you know, and just stops in and wants to talk. And you know, so, you know, him and Matt Mims and I talked, and, you know, the first things he says, he wants to make sure all of our student athletes and everybody feel safe and feel supported and obviously loved. And so to be able to have that support and leadership in our athletic department is really special, and we're very thankful.
We've got a lot more to come here on our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. We'll talk about where things sit in the Summit League at the moment in men's basketball, and it is wild and crazy. It's like Jenga, trying to figure out where everybody's at right now with the different numbers of games played. We'll talk about that and the opponent scheduled for this week, the University of North Dakota, with the head coach of the SDSU men, Eric Henderson, when our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues. It is presented by our friends at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, and this is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus, hey, daily Tyler. Food and drink Tyler. Specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
In the truck game, greatness is defined by a relentless commitment to the customer. Forged over decades and built by a team resolute in helping you achieve your greatness. Experience the all-new 2021 Ford F-150 and Ford Super Duty for a performance like no other. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling truck for 44 years straight and counting. Based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Director's Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
So this thing says at the end, let's go be 56:30, you go to 57:30, you save, I got nothing at the end of the hour.
Plan,
you okay with that?
You protect. If you want to secure your legacy, First Bank and Trust offers savvy financial planning from people who understand where you are and where you want to go. We can help you navigate your options and build for the future, wherever that may be. Okay. We're big enough to help you plan for tomorrow and small enough to start with today. First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. Okay. Member FDIC, equal opportunity lender.
We got 90 seconds.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
Visit Royal River in Flandreau. Blast your way through winter at Royal River in Flandreau. Every Friday and Saturday from 5 to 10 p.m., you could win a Cub Cadet snow thrower and earn entries to win a new Kawasaki Mule plus winch and blade on February 27th. Plus, wake up Royal every Wednesday from 8 to 8. Earn 100 points on your Royal Rewards card and receive your Brentwood appliance. First come, first serve. Royal River Casino Hotel. Must be 21.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, the presenting sponsor of our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. We welcome you back inside the West Tower of Dana J. Dykal Stadium. We are up on the sixth floor, living large inside the President's Suite. I don't know if he knows we're in here with Eric Henderson, the head coach of the Jackrabbit Men. I'm Tyler Merriam. Again, a reminder, if you do not have the Jackrabbit app on your mobile device, download it today. Among the many things that is offered, including access to your season ticket account, all the links and live reminders, you'll get app notifications for this show every Monday night with how you can watch our video stream or how you can listen to it. In addition to all of the events, you'll get score notifications. Everything you need to know about Jackrabbit Athletics on the Jackrabbit app, download it on your mobile device today. It is free in the Apple or Google Play stores. And All right, Hendo. Summit League standings at the moment. It's a jumbled mess because you have USD at 4-0, your squad's 2-0, 5-1 Oral Roberts, 5-1 North Dakota State. Each of those teams losing a game they felt like they let get away, ironically enough, both to North Dakota, who sits at 3-3. Then you have 1-3 Kansas City and three teams at 0-4 in Western Illinois, Omaha, and Denver. Is there anything we can make out of this at this point?
Well, I'm not sure, to be frank with you. I think it's way too early, you know. And obviously, when you're playing the same team back-to-back nights, you know, we're not going to see Western Illinois again until, you know, maybe the conference tournament, you know. So I think, you know, how we've approached it as a staff is we're not going to worry about that. Let's worry about things we can control. And that's our next opponent in North Dakota. We're not going to worry about where we sit in the standings. We're just, you know, happy that we can play games and we get to play games, to be real honest.
You saw the University of North Dakota, who you are scheduled to play Friday and Saturday night, 7:30, the tip slated for each night in Frost Arena. Saw them in Sioux Falls a month ago. You're a little different team, didn't have Douglas Wilson in that game. They're a little different team as well. And they're still trying to figure things out, aside from one thing. They know their best offensive option, and everybody in the Summit League knows it's Philip Rabracha. Man, is he an offensive machine inside.
Special player, really. You know, he takes a lot of focus of your a lot of your attention when you're putting together a scouting report. That's for sure. I mean, he's very crafty down there, steps out to the three-point line. He's made, you know, I think 10 threes on these, 7 threes on the year, and so he's certainly capable of making them. And you have to really think about how you're going to guard him first and then kind of go from there. And like you said, they're playing a lot different than they were, you know, December 11th, I think, is when we played them. You know, they're playing a few different guys. But probably more importantly, the guys are getting comfortable with each other. They brought in a lot of new guys this year that, you know, hadn't played a lot together. And the more you play together, a little easier it gets, or a little more comfortable you get, I should say. So, you know, they've made some strides. So we'll have our hands full here on Friday and Saturday.
And one thing you know for sure, if it's a Paul Sather coach team, that dude can coach.
He's a good coach. You know, good man, good coach. He really does. He'll put a plan together. His guys will follow the plan. And he's going to make you beat him. You know, they're not going to beat themselves. So, we got to be ready to go. And you know, these back-to-back nights, we've talked about it before, that the team that can let that first night go, you know, that's what you got to do, is put yourself in good positions.
We talked about how a couple of weeks ago you were a Matt Mims away from being fully healthy again. How is Mims coming along?
Mims, he's been great. You know, this weekend I think was good for him. We took, you know, Saturday off and practiced late Sunday night, and I think that really helped him. So he practiced full go on Sunday night, and he went again this morning at 8 o'clock, bright and early this morning when they didn't have school. They were real happy with Coach Hendo there, Tyler, but it was fun to see, you know, it was fun to see our whole crew back together. So hopefully we can get through the rest of this week and be ready to go with our full squad.
Before I let you run, I got about a minute and a half left here. One thing that did come out after we talked a week ago Monday was the fact that the Summit League tournament is moving to the Sanford Pentagon, and you've already played 6 games there. It's like a home away from home for you, it seems like. But under these circumstances, to move into that facility, I mean, really seemed like a slam dunk, no pun intended.
Yeah, it's we're pretty fortunate to be able to have that situation, you know, and that opportunity to have that right there in Sioux Falls. And you know, Tyler, you know, that Bad Boy Classic, I think we won 1 game.
You did.
That Dakota Classic, we won 2 games. The next time in Sioux Falls, let's try to win 3 games. What do you think?
It cracks me up every time you say Bad Boy Classic.
I don't know why.
Because it was the Bad Boy Mowers sponsored the Crossover Classic. Sounds like it's some, you know, kids getting out of jail, the Bad Boys Classic.
Well, I'm sorry to make it sound like that, but no, we're excited. I know that we're excited to obviously just to be able to get in that environment. Unfortunate for our fans and for our guys too, because I do, as you're well aware, it's a special for everybody. I think it's a little extra special for those Jackrabbits.
It certainly is. Hendo, thank you. Good luck this week. Again, North Dakota, the opposition, Friday and Saturday, 5 o'clock doubleheaders. Start with the women, follow with the men. For Hendo and AJ, I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Right,
the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show has been brought to you by Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Sanford Health. Thanks.
Golf lives here. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Case IH. Step up your game with top-performing Case IH equipment. State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Midco SN. This is how we do sports. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original and your sports headquarters. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. The preceding has been a Learfield IMG College presentation.